Son of God hanging on a hill. Hell was my destiny. The crowd was shouting, crucify. Could have come from these lips of mine. The dirty shame was killing me. It would take a miracle to wash me clean. Then I
good evening. We're glad you're joining us tonight for the Harvest Festival. We're going to go ahead and get started this evening. We're going to start with a little bit of a time of worship, and that will hopefully, as the sound of all of your beautiful voices are raised in thanksgiving, as we raise a hallelujah together, that will hopefully bring everyone that's still making their way in into the auditorium so that then they can get seated and then we can eat, because I know that's what we're here for tonight, the Soupapalooza, so... let's all stand as we begin, then. We're just going to raise a hallelujah as we spend some time worshiping God together.
Hallelujah, my a melody. I raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me.
Goodness of God. All right, am I on now? Okay, good evening. My name is Kevin DeRoos, and I want to welcome each and every one of you here tonight. Can you guys believe it's been 2 years since we've been able to meet together like this? Isn't that good? We are family here tonight, right? Liberty Evangelical Free Church family. And this is our annual Harvest Festival. And I'm going to pray for us, and then I'll give you instructions on what we're supposed to do, okay? Let's go ahead and pray. Heavenly Father, we do thank you for this day. We thank you for this evening that we can gather together as a family. Believers in Jesus Christ who want to have a good time, who want to fellowship together, sing together, and laugh together. We thank you for this evening and for all the food that has been prepared. I just pray that you would bless our time and our fellowship together. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, some quick instructions here. We're going to try and keep the evening moving along well. I am going to release everybody by tables. I've got all the numbers here, so there's no favoritism. Okay. 11? Did I hear 11? Okay. Gotcha, George. Okay, here's how we're going to do it. I will release a few tables at a time, and you will go out that door over there on the far side to the east. You will get your food, and you will come in this door over here on the west side. Nobody is to go out that center door unless there's an emergency. Okay? There are tables on each side of the auditorium here with water. And after you get your food, you can go over and get something to drink. Does that sound like a plan? Anybody hungry? All right. Okay. All right. Here we go. Table 37. Okay. Table 17. Really? I did not do that. I did not plan it that way. Okay. Table 3. Is anybody at table 3? Over there. Okay. Table number 26. Table number 26. Is my microphone on?
Yes, it is.
Okay, another table, table number 19. Two more? Okay, table number 10. Table number 10. Table number 9. Table number 9. Let's go with table 29, table number 29. Table number 33, table number 33. You can go through the line. Thank you.
Table number 28. Table number 28. Table number 4. Table number 4. Is there a table number 4? Okay. Table number 35. Table 35. Table number 18. Table number 18. Table number 16. Table number 16. Table number 24. Table number 24. Table number 11. Table number 14. Table number 14. Table number 15. Table number 15. Table number 6. Table number 6. Is there a table number 6? Right there? Okay. Table 13. Table 13. Table number 8. Table number 8. Table number 7. Table number 7. Table number 25. Table 25. Table 31. Table 31. table number 5? Table number 5. Table number 32. Table 34. Table 27.
How many more do you have?
Six. Table 1. Table 1. Table 30. Table 30. Table 2. Table number 2. No table 2. Table 12. Is there a table 12? Oh, okay. Table 23. Table Okay. Table 21. And last but not least, table 20. Table 20. Now, is there any table that I have missed yet? Okay, I think everybody has had a chance to go through the line. We're going to start here in just a few minutes, but I want you to know that anytime throughout the evening, please feel free to go back and get more food as long as you want to. That's not a problem at all, okay? So if anybody needs to use the restroom, there's some down both hallways, and we'll start here in 2-3 minutes, okay? Okay, folks, I think we're just about ready to get started. So if everybody wants to find a seat, and like I said, feel free to keep getting food if you're hungry. We don't want anybody to go away hungry tonight. Okay, at this time, our program will begin.
We have their attention. Good evening. Welcome to LEFC Station.
We're coming to you live from Pella, Iowa, the station for the nation to show what we know.
The Christian on a mission to give what we live.
Where our statement hits the pavement.
Hello, I'm Jessica Gladtower.
And I'm Alicia Jones.
Welcome to the 2021 live show. Now, we want you to just sit back, relax, and enjoy tonight's entertainment. But first, we have an editorial we'd like to bring to you. It seems there has been a huge problem with squirrels in the church attic. So we want to give you our little report. If we can find it. Oh. Good, you brought yours too. Good.
So first, we'll tell you, the Presbyterian Church called a meeting to decide what to do about their squirrel infestation. After much prayer and consideration, they concluded that the squirrels were predestined to be there, and they should not interfere with God's divine will.
Okay. Now, at the Baptist Church, the squirrels had taken an interest in their baptistry. The deacons met and decided to put a water slide in the baptistry and let the squirrels drown themselves. Oh, the squirrels liked the slide and unfortunately knew how to, instinctively, how to swim. So twice as many squirrels showed up for the following week.
Then you have the Lutheran Church. They decided that they were not in position to harm any of God's creatures. No.
Amen, sister.
So they humbly trapped their squirrels and set them free nearby the Baptist church. 2 weeks later, the squirrels were back when the Baptists took down the waterside.
Now, the Episcopalians tried a much more unique path to the setting. They set out buckets of wine around their church in the effort to kill the squirrels with alcohol poisoning. They sadly learned how much damage a band of squirrels who were drunk with alcohol poisoning. Couldn't work.
Now the Catholic Church came up with a more creative approach. They baptized all the squirrels and made them members of the church. Now they only see them at Christmas and Easter.
Okay. Oh, now, not much was heard from the Jewish synagogue. They took the first squirrel and circumcised him. They haven't seen a squirrel since.
<Let's see. laughs> That's good.
Sorry, folks. I'm new. Okay. Where are we?
Just read from there.
Nope, that's Grandpa's kit. That's the very last one.
Here we go. Wow! I missed that one. That must have been how it felt for Noah.
Nope, that's going to be the second act. Oh, I'm telling you what.
You told me page two.
We're going to go to page one again.
Here we go. Page okay. One. And now we move to the entertainment section of the show. You thought you were already there, right?
Stop it. You're so crazy.
Our first performers are a group of men. How interesting. Let's take a look.
While the stage is being set up, let me give you a little history lesson on Liberty Evangelical Free Church. It was established in 1991 at the Community Center in downtown Pella. As the congregation grew, we moved to the gymnasium at the Pella Christian Grade School the next year. We broke ground on this land that we're on right now in 2003 and held our first service in the gym in 2006. The education wing was also completed at that time for Sunday school and other activities. The BIT team was formed to oversee the construction of the building site. BIT stands for Building Implementation Team, and they met regularly to make sure everything stayed on course. Many church members were blessed with construction skills and worked alongside the hired professionals who put up the main framework. Until 2011, this space we are in right now was known as our large storage room. We were finally able to start church services in the sanctuary in 2016. Other projects continued until we were finished just this year. Many weekends were spent here by people dedicating their time to see this church completed. We would like to show you what a somewhat typical Saturday work day would look like. Oh yes, and so that no actor will be harmed, sound effects will be provided. Bang, bang, ow, ow, mommy. Ka-ching, ka-ching.
ka-ching, ka-ching.
Ding, 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 ding. Break time. Who brought the donuts? The end.
No, we have, because that was the wrong. That
was
the
wrong. Yeah.
Are you turned on?
I am.
Okay. Go ahead. They're setting up the next one.
Wow. That must have been how it felt for Noah when he built the ark.
I know that you weren't around here when the project was underway, but believe me, this storage unit was huge. But doesn't it look wonderful now?
Yes, indeed. Looks like the men did a fabulous job. And Lois.
Lois always. I believe that it is time for our next performers. Something about a park bench and a sunny afternoon.
Say it again.
good afternoon, ma'am. I said, good afternoon, ma'am.
I'm not deaf, I'm just reading.
This seat wasn't taken, was it?
No.
Sure is a good looking dog. Man, the sky's beautiful today. It kind of looks like an elephant, doesn't it?
You ask a lot of questions. Are you like a detective or something?
No, ma'am. I'm just a plumber. I'm working at that church across the street today, and I'd just taken a late lunch. What kind of dog that is? Kind of looks like a Dalmatian. Or maybe a Great Dane. He looks like he wants my sandwich. I have some crackers. You think he'd want a cracker?
He's a dog, not a parrot. But I suspect he would.
Well, say, I forgot to ask, does your dog bite?
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
I said, does your dog bite?
No, my dog does not.
Oh, hey, I thought you said your dog doesn't bite.
That's what I said.
Then how do you explain that?
That is not my dog. This is my dog. Let's go home, Polly.
Boy, I sure hope that gentleman had his tetanus shot. I thought the dog might be friendly. Oh well. I see here that we have a lovely group of ladies next to sing for us. Let's have a listen.
Okay.
So I've had the privilege over the years to work with some youth. And one of the things that I think is really fun is watching them grow up and go away to college and maybe possibly meet someone very special. And sometimes they're even able to come back and at liberty be able to celebrate by having their ceremony, their special ceremony here at our church because it's so beautiful now. I mean, you saw the construction that went into this church. You saw it earlier in a skit. And we thought it would be very similar to like they were going to the chapel.
Going to the chapel and we're gonna get married. Going to the chapel and we're gonna get married. Gee, I really love you and we're gonna get married. Going to the chapel of love. Spring is here, the
Liberty, we also have some very special senior saints, and we don't want to let them, you know, not have a song, a special song for them. So we thought that a special song for them would be like reminiscing, remembering those good old days and those times you shared together through those, through that marriage, and that's what this song is all about.
I wanna make you smile whenever you're sad. Carry you around when your arthritis is bad. All I wanna do is grow old with you.
Old with you.
I'll get your medicine when your tummy aches. Build you a fire when the furnace breaks.
Sometimes they take them, and then you're like, hey!
I really thought you were going to fall over there.
It was a close one. You know, I'm sometimes you think you're, like, poised and balanced, and you're walking, and then they're all looking at you, and then all of a sudden, bam, there you are on the floor in front of everybody.
And so then you break your leg.
Yeah, yeah. Then everybody at church for the next few Sundays, they're like, oh, I saw that. Oh, it was real bad.
Did you? Yeah, secretly they were laughing. I was one of them, sorry.
Oh, thanks. I thought we were friends here.
Oh, we're always friends.
Sisters in Christ.
Yes. Okay. Now, that was entertainment to me for sure. I always enjoy the singing. Going to the chapel, one of my favorites. But the song that they were singing about the older couple kind of thing, mine was more like... true love or something. I don't know. I didn't really understand it. Now, I'll have to talk to my grandmother and grandpa about that one. But it was beautiful.
Got it. We won't tell your husband.
No.
Okay. Anyways.
Okay. Now, looking here, looking at our itinerary, our last piece of the show looks to be like a showstopper. This should be interesting. It is called Grandpa Gets Homeschooled.
Dad, thank you so much for coming. The spa called, and I had a last-minute cancellation, and I had to go. I'll get the kids. Kids, Grandpa's here. Please behave. Okay, Dad, their lessons are right here. They shouldn't be hard. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Okay, have fun. Okay, kids, come on down. School is in session. Okay, looks like we're all here. I guess I better take roll. Judy.
Actually, Grandpa, it's Judith.
Oh, okay. Judith. Billy.
Here.
Tommy.
Here.
Susie.
Mommy let me dress myself today.
That's quite an outfit. Beautiful. Okay, why don't y'all take your seats, and we will get started with reading. Okay. Okay, Judy, will you please read the first sentence?
It's Judith. The dog is playing too rough.
I'm sorry, Judith. It's a good job. Now, Tommy, will you read the next sentence?
Grandma rolled out the cookie duff.
No. It's cookie dough.
Why? The first sentence was spelled duff. It should be cookie duff.
I don't know. They're spelled the same. They do sound different. Trust me. You know what? That's enough for reading. Okay, let's work on spelling. Spelling will be good. Let's see here now. Can any of you spell the word apple?
Yes.
Okay, who can spell apple?
We can.
Cat.
I can spell cat. C-A-T, cat.
Well, Susie, thank you. That's really nice. But I really need help spelling apple. Billy?
Apple. A-P-P-L-E. Apple. You know, Grandpa, if you really need help with your spelling, you can always ask Grandma.
Help with spelling? Okay. You know what? That's enough spelling. How about if we go on to arithmetic?
Oh, good. Math is my favorite.
Okay, me too. Now, I have five. I take away two. How many do I have? Judith.
Two.
No, now watch. I have five. I take away two. How many do I have? Boys?
Two.
Susie, how many fingers am I holding up?
One, two, three. You have three fingers, Grandpa.
That's right. I have three. Now, let's try this again. Okay? I've got five. I take away two. How many do I have?
Two.
Okay, this is not working. Let's try something else. I just happen to have some apples. Let's just say that Johnny has 5 apples.
Ooh, can I be Johnny?
Yes, Billy, whatever it takes to move this along. Okay. Johnny has 5 apples. I take 2. How many apples do I have?
2.
Why do you keep saying 2?
Because Grandpa has, Billy has 5 apples.
I'm Johnny.
Johnny has 5 apples. He did not take any, so he has 0. You took 2, so you have 2. Here are 3. 3 plus 2 equals 5.
Oh, my.
Can we go outside for recess now?
Yes, yes, please do.
Can I have an apple?
Yes, help yourself.
Are you coming with us, Johnny?
Grandpa?
Yes, sweetheart?
Can I have an apple too, please?
Sure.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Grandpa?
Yes, Susie?
Now you only have 1.
What just happened here?
You're on here. Oh, you're so wonderful for sharing. Poor, poor Grandpa. He looked so confused.
But didn't that little Susie look adorable?
Oh, for sure. Well, they're getting ready to finish here. Can you go ahead?
Yes. All right, so please stick around. There will be a couple more worship songs. Thank you for staying tuned to LEFC. This is Alicia Jones signing off.
Sorry. And this is, who am I again? Oh, Jessica Gladtower. Oh, we hope you had some fun tonight. Stay tuned for the music.
They think the battery's dead in this. Is that accurate?
Hello, hello.
Is it good? Is it good?
One thing, as we get ready to close out our time together this evening, we want to end in a time of worship again. And can we just have a hand for all those brave souls that came up on stage tonight and were willing to share their talents with us? And also, how about a hand for all of the great and delicious food we had this evening? What an amazing spread of food out there. It was awesome just to get a time to fellowship together. The skit about the building of this church was strikingly realistic in that this church building came about because a bunch of people, men and women, who didn't really know what they were doing, spent a lot of time in prayer. We started at this church in 1994, and when we started, there was a discussion at that point in time about, we're going to find some land, we're going to build a building. And we went off to Eastern Iowa and came back in 2001, and we started coming to Liberty again, and people told us, hey, we bought some land, we're going to build a building. We're like, that's what you said 7 years ago. And then it happened, and we started the building process, and we moved in here. We had our first Sunday in this church building in the gym. It was a little rough, but we had it there, end of May 2005. And to see where this church has come since that time is truly just a testament to the power that God and the blessings that God has given us to here in the Liberty Evangelical Free Church family. So we are so blessed. Sometimes we take for granted when we walk in the front of this church that 15 years ago, this was just an empty field. And now it's a mission field for us. So we want to close our time tonight with just a couple worship songs. If you would stand and join us and just let's praise God. There's only one reason that this church exists, and that's because we are a body of believers united in Christ, our living hope.
Thank you.
that hope in Jesus because of the grace that he gives us. We want to close tonight celebrating amazing grace. Thank you so much. We have so much to be thankful for. We're so blessed to be the body of Christ. We just hope you've enjoyed this evening. We thank you to all the deaconesses, the people that worked on the stage tonight that volunteered their time and talents and efforts. Just how about a round of applause for those that planned and programmed this evening. It's been a blessing to share, to break bread, enjoy ham sandwiches and soup together tonight. And chili, lots of chili. I apologize to all of those of you that ate chili tonight. Tomorrow's going to be rough for some of you. So let's just close this time in prayer. And then after that, if you're a high school student, we hate to tell you this, but we're going to jet out of here and we're going to go down. We're going to have some youth group and do some worship and learn tonight some more to just enjoy our time together. So please feel free to stay in fellowship. If you see high school kids running out of here, they're not going to get in trouble, hopefully. So let's pray together. God, we just thank you for this time. Lord, we thank you for the way that you've blessed this church body. We see you at work in this body and the relationships that are built. We just thank you that we could gather together tonight, share some time of laughter, some time of worship, and just a time that we could renew friendships and spend time deepening our relationships. We pray, God, that you'll help us to grow together. We thank you for the chance to serve each other this evening. And we just pray that our church body will be one that shares the gospel with the world around us, that we can bring others here. We pray for safety as we travel home tonight. Bless us, sweet God. We just thank you for who you are and your amazing grace that you gave to us. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
Crystal clear, is about the one who's gonna solve them. Oh, I need something that can fill my soul. Oh, on a record on the radio, ain't nothing like a gospel song. Makes me wanna sing it all day long. Something about that amazing grace, sound of praise, makes my troubles not seem so strong. Let me hear a heart set free. Stop and testify. I was dead and brought to life.